For 2018, I think we saw another year of an increased awareness in the industrial segments of the different applications that additive manufacturing can support. The application-driven approach is getting more and more attention, and you see that coming from, let's say, the financing world, where today several investment funds are claiming that they don't want to invest in machine manufacturers anymore. They are looking for startups that apply 3D printing in certain domains. Today, they are looking at methodologies to stimulate consultancy and co-creation so that a wide group of industries starts using 3D printing. And this is the way that they create a market and a demand for a product rather than a supply for a non-existing market. So that's why I believe that the application-driven approach, the creation or the stimulation of the user demand, is really going to accelerate 3D printing or additive manufacturing further.
With regards to materials, the main trends for 3D printing in 2019 will more work in the opposite direction of the well-known phrase, less is more. So we'll be seeing more different materials, and we'll be able to target a more application-based approach rather than a technology-driven approach. 3D printing and materials has always been a catch-22 story, whereas you see that materials are not being developed because they're not processable on commercial available machines. There is a drive now that is fueled by the willingness and the versatility of the large material suppliers and producers to enable this push in technologies. And that means that there's still a steadfast growth in the importance of 3D printed plastics. Many highly demanding industries like aerospace and automotive have a demand for materials that are different than the ones that we are currently supplying. At the moment, they are willing to make compromises in order to make advances in additive manufacturing in any way. But in the future, with new material developments, it will not be necessary anymore to compromise. They can go towards the materials they actually want to use for their applications, either in functional prototypes or even in series manufacturing.
If you look at the evolutions that 3D printing has undergone over the past decades, there's clearly this start in rapid prototyping, and from there it evolved into end parts. I think the big evolution that we see happening nowadays is that 3D printing is being adopted for serial manufacturing, really mass manufacturing. A lot of companies have been looking at 3D printing and are integrating it into their reality. Now, in order for it to become part of that reality and really to make it stick within that ecosystem of mass manufacturing, productivity of the technology is a key element. The industry needs to increase productivity, so software plays a key role in doing that. How? Well, by looking at a number of ways to automate tasks. Automating steps that not just reduce labor, but also improve efficiency of your entire process. By automating steps, you can enhance the number of parts that are put on a specific machine. By working on simulation of the process, also a hot topic nowadays, by incorporating the 3D printing process, combining that with simulation capabilities, before the build actually starts, look at things that could go wrong and prevent those by taking countermeasures. And if you prevent things from going wrong during a build, you prevent crashes, you prevent waste, scrap from coming out of that production process, and in doing so, seriously reduce the waste and thus increase overall profitability.
In view of the relation with 3D printing players, you have the traditional players that have been 3D printing like Materialise for the last 20 years. Those have already relatively strong relations, and I think they will only get stronger. Next to that, where I see the biggest change is new players entering the market. So for the last few years, we have seen companies that have a traditional ground in traditional manufacturing, they are entering the 3D printing arena from a completely other perspective than that we have been working it for the past 20 years. And there is a lot of complementarity, and I see a lot of opportunities. I see a few advantages. So at one side, making the process smoother will make it also more cost competitive. At the other hand, I really expect that it will also enable more designers, getting people up to speed that are not at the 3D printing knowledgeable today. A third access I see is that in a lot of cases, ordering a 3D printed part is not easy because of the way 3D printing is set up as a silo environment. So there we're also looking at how to make it easier for people to order parts and to have them manufactured. So I'm really convinced that in terms of 3D printing manufacturing, we're still in the very early stages of the product lifecycle. Working with the early adapters and the innovators, and working together with partners that have their ground in manufacturing, we can increase the amount of people involved in 3D printing.
Why I think that government has an increased interest in 2019 in 3D printing is because we have basically reached a level of maturity now. We're moving more and more towards the manufacturing technology, so that means that 3D printing also has a real life consequence on their citizens. That being said, it hasn't always been easy for a government to see the forest through the trees. We use the term 3D printing for basically everything. Printing plastics, but also printing houses, printing organs. We cannot do everything. And by saying that we can, it makes it really hard for a government to estimate what the possible risks are of this industry and what they have to protect their citizens from and what they should empower. I think the main concerns for the government are basically in two places. On the one hand, you have intellectual property, IP. On the other hand, product liability. What the government is afraid of is basically they're afraid that 3D printing could do to the physical objects world what the internet has done to the music and movie industry. I do not think that the government is completely wrong in thinking that 3D printing will definitely disrupt supply chains. I'm convinced that a part of the value will shift from the material object to the digital file. So we have to think about how do we regulate CAD files. I think with a couple of smart tweaks that we can get really, really far. What I do think is that it's really important that we as an industry get involved, that we talk to governments and that we explain to them what our technology can do and maybe even more important what it cannot do and will never be able to do. And with this, we can help them to create a good and safe regulatory framework that protects their citizens, that protects the designers, that protects possible patients.
Personally, I think in 2019, we don't have to hope for an enormous explosion of the market, but at the same time, we certainly don't have to be pessimistic, because the steady growth will continue, and the steady growth will deliver an increasing amount of customers for additive manufacturing, and an increasing amount of companies that convert existing traditional manufacturing methods